can manipulate, dominate, control.
I killed 87 people in a period of 17 years.
You got intentions, you got bad intentions.
I'm like, oh my God, I did it again. Is there no end?
Criminal profiler John Douglas has spent his life studying the serial killer. He's talked with dozens of them. He's helped police catch them. He's written books identifying the obsessions that haunt them. According to Douglas, the overriding motivation for these sadistic killers is pleasure. They enjoy killing.
They want to see the tears streaming down that victim's face. They want to make that victim beg. And if he's a killer, he wants to be the executioner.
We've enlisted Douglas to use his skills and knowledge to profile one of the most infamous and elusive serial killers we've ever profiled, the Zodiac Killer, a faceless menace who killed at least 5 people in 1 year. The Zodiac struck in the late 60s in San Francisco, at first targeting teens out on a date at Lover's Lane.
Everything that they represent there, this relationship, this bonding between the young male and the young female, this person has never had.
But according to Douglas, those first killings didn't satisfy the Zodiac's lust for blood. As with many serial killers, the reality of the kill didn't live up to the fantasy. So he morphed into a more sinister character, wearing a costume, tying up his victims, using a knife.
I'm not going to shoot you. I am going to stab you both.
This was a better thrill for him. He would enjoy that a lot better than the more impersonal way of just going up to people and blitzing them.
For no reason at all. That's about the worst I ever seen. The kids just chopped up, real nice college kids, just stabbed for no reason at all. I never witnessed anything like it before.
The murders terrified San Francisco, making headlines daily, which only fed the Zodiac's obsession. To ensure his infamous status, he began taunting the police and the press.
I want to report a double murder.
He took credit for his crimes, enjoying the limelight. Cryptograms he sent contained coded messages, exposing his psychotic fantasies. When decoded, the messages began, "I like killing people because it's so much fun."
What it tells you about the person, too, is he's very obsessive compulsive. It would take hours and hours and maybe days to put this all together. But what he's doing here, he's telling us how bright he is. He's telling us, he's a lot smarter than the rest of the world.
Letter after letter arrived to police with a Zodiac claiming to have killed again and again, until finally the most terrifying letter of all, threatening the assassination of school children, sending the public into a panic. But Douglas believes he never intended to kill those kids.
These children represent even himself, helpless, hopeless, innocent children. He could have had a life like that, but he knew that by making this threat, that would be a way for him, again, to manipulate law enforcement.
The Zodiac's fifth cold-blooded murder was against a cab driver. After the press had tried to pigeonhole him as a lady killer, the Zodiac set out to prove them wrong.
So I think his message then was, when he took the life of that cab driver, was, hey, you got your psychology boys all messed up here. I can kill men. So he zaps him. He hits him with a bullet in the back of his head.
After that, some more communications with the police. Then, nothing. They never discovered who the Zodiac really was. But our expert has some insight.
If you would one day find him and find his room and go through his belongings, he would have every newspaper clipping, every story that's ever been written about him. He would have his own personal diaries where he's communicating to himself.
The Zodiac struck in the late 60s, but it seems his influence carried on for decades. Other notorious serial killers seem to have mimicked the Zodiac. In New York, one serial killer even called himself the Zodiac. Heriberto Seda shot 4 people in 4 months. Ted Kaczynski, the infamous Unabomber, wrote rambling letters to the press and law enforcement, much like the Zodiac did. And his intricate bomb designs show a similar personality.
If you take a look at Ted Kaczynski, the so-called Unabomber, it's the same kind of thing, making these devices. He had this obsessive compulsive personality, and he better have an obsessive compulsive personality to make the kind of bombs he made, because these things would blow up in his face.
The serial killer who most resembles the Zodiac is David Berkowitz, New York's Son of Sam, whose choice of victims paralleled the Zodiac's. He wrote bizarre letters to newspaper columnist Jimmy Breslin.
in the game, no question about it. I think he gets a kick out of it.
But unlike the Zodiac, he got caught. And so now he's sitting in jail and sits there and he fantasizes and he obsesses today. And you interview him, he can remember every specific detail of the crime. It's just like replaying a favorite CD over and over in his brain. And there's no remorse, whatsoever.
Berkowitz claims now to have found God, even going so far as to star in a video for other criminals, entitled Son of Sam, Son of Hope.
Being the son of Sam was the biggest waste. It was the biggest lie.
He claims to have been possessed by evil when he committed those horrific crimes, and that he has overcome that evil. But according to Douglas, no serial killer can overcome their obsession. Even Berkowitz, even the Zodiac, if he's still out there.
The obsession and the fantasy stays there. You can't take it from them, no matter what you do. You can torture them, but you can't take that fantasy or that obsession away.
If Sam got caught, probably still be doing it.
What I did, I snapped him, and I just went off. And then I just kept going off.
If you were to be released at noon tomorrow, what would you do?
Take a nice bath, eat a nice dinner, and I would probably commit a murder before nightfall.
So if the Zodiac is still alive, how did he stop his killing spree? How did he keep from giving in to the obsession?
I have seen cases where that they just suddenly stopped, and they just then would just go back into the fantasy and just kind of sit back in that lazy boy chair and pull out your scrapbook and think of your memories and of what you did, and that's enough to get them through it.